I'm Jay Horton. I make movies that make money. This is how. Last week, I went over how I start out marketing before a movie is even shot. Today, we're going to talk about what comes right after. Social media posting. This is probably the thing I spend the most time on when it comes to marketing. And I found this is where I get the most out of my marketing traction with a mix of paid and free organic posting. When it comes to posting on social media, keep this rule of thumb in mind. Make 2 regular posts to every 1 self-promotional post. Meaning you make 2 posts completely unrelated to your movie or filmmaking for every post you make that promotes your movie or your filmmaking. Now there are folks out there that will say that these ratios are different for different platforms, and heck, they're probably right. And if you want to dig deeper and look those up, go for it. For me, I like to keep it relatively simple. For example, on Facebook, I don't like to do any more than 2 self-promotional posts a day on my main wall. And more often than not, I do just 1. And I think that 1 self-promotional post a day on your personal accounts is pretty good on basically all of the platforms. Another thing you can do to up that ratio a little bit is to make use of your stories. Because they disappear after 24 hours, it doesn't really clutter your main wall up. This is especially helpful if you have more than 1 thing to push on any given day. I use my stories for these additional posts. And I follow pretty much the same rules on Twitter, TikTok, and Instagram. Now, if you're not good with social media or feel awkward about it, get started now and get used to it. If your movie isn't out yet, practice by promoting someone else's. Another thing you can do, and really you should have been doing this anyway during the build-up to your release, is build more connections. On Facebook, keep friending new, relevant people. People in your target audience. Follow new people on Twitter, Instagram, and TikTok. But the real trick here is to not just follow and friend randos, but people that are firmly in your target audience. So let's talk for a quick second about what to post. Of course, you'll want to share the link to wherever your movie is or your IMDb reviews, but you may find that you'll get more reach and brand awareness by not posting the link at all on some posts. Facebook, for example, is said to not give as much reach to posts that have links in them. Oh, and here's something really important. You'll need a lot of material to post. Way more than just a couple of posters and a trailer. So create a bunch of extra material to share. This is what I do. I make 12 to 20, 30 to 45 second teaser clips from the movie itself directly. I think of these as basically longer form GIFs. I try to choose bits of scenes that make some kind of sense outside the context of the movie or the entire scene itself. These work best if you end on some sort of a cliffhanger. Keep the viewers craving, wanting to know what's going to happen next. You can use these for Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, Reddit, and I'll create a few shorter ones for TikTok. But honestly, so far, I haven't got a lot of traction with this sort of thing there, but I keep experimenting. When it comes to posting across multiple social media platforms, you should stagger your posts. Don't post the same exact thing on multiple platforms at the same time, or really even the same day. And you should really tailor your individual posts for each platform. Although that said, there are some instances when you're posting pics or short videos that an identical post might work just as well. The next thing I'll create is 10 short behind-the-scenes clips. Interviews with me or the cast, around 60 seconds max, 45 seconds is ideal. On my documentaries, this is often one that I miss, but I know that it helps from the narratives that I've done. Then I'll create 5 to 10 longer clips from the movies, like 3 to 5 minutes apiece, full scenes. I try and use the whole scene or sequence when I can. Stuff that'll intrigue the audience, but not give too much away. And again, like the shorter clips, you want something that kind of makes sense without context. Now, for these longer clips, I pretty much make these exclusively for YouTube to start out. Then, after all of them have been posted, I'll start all over again a few weeks later and start reposting 1 a week on Facebook, like on the Facebook business page. But back to YouTube. Once I finish these, I'll post one of these longer videos, one a week, maybe two a week, depending on your YouTube channel and the kind of audience that you have. Do all of your SEO homework, descriptions and tags. Every time one of these videos publishes on your YouTube channel, share it across all your other social media platforms and cherry-picked Facebook groups and subreddits. One quick word on sharing and posting in groups. Have a written out schedule or spreadsheet. Use it to keep track of where and when you're posting in what groups. That way you're not posting the same thing in the same group twice, and you can keep track of your promo to non-promo post ratio. Pull still images from the movie and create art with overlays and text. Get creative, make some memes, but you can also just do some straight up stills from the movie. It's good to keep things mixed up. You just don't want to keep posting the exact same type of material over and over and over again. You want a variety. You can never have too much material. I aim to have at least one new image or piece of promotional content to share daily for the first 90 days of my film's release. Let's talk for a second about posting in groups. And I'm mostly talking about Facebook here, but this also applies to Reddit. And a word of warning on Reddit, really check out the subreddit before you start posting. Many groups will ban you pretty much instantly for blatant spam. Back to Facebook groups. Now, as far as my ratio for posting in groups, I do this a little bit differently than on my personal wall. Here, I'll use a 1-to-1 ratio. One regular post unrelated to your specific film for every self-promotional post. I post no more than 2 times a week in every group as noted above. One regular post, one self-promotional post. Now, the one place where I kind of break this rule is like when I'm promoting this YouTube channel. I tend to post in filmmaking groups, and there are groups where the only thing I really post are posts for my YouTube channel. But I feel like in this case, because, you know, I'm doing videos that directly relate to that content, you know, they're like tailor-made for those groups. So I don't feel so bad just posting those in the groups. And if your movie falls into that category, there's nothing wrong with just doing the self-promotional posts. But if not, really make sure to do the ratio thing. One regular post, one self-promotional post. And also, it's a good idea to comment on some other posts in between there. When it comes to these groups, pay attention to where and how you're getting engagement. If after 3 weeks you've been posting in this same group over and over again and you're getting zero engagement, either completely change your posting style or just delete that group. Stop wasting your time there. Don't waste time posting somewhere where you're not getting engagement. You're just spinning your wheels. And one way that you can really increase your engagement, respond to the comments that you do get. Always be polite and thankful. Do not negatively engage in criticism. If someone gets critical, just thank them for their feedback or give them a thumbs up and ignore it. If it's an awful troll, just ignore it. Remove your ego from the situation. Your goal here is to increase engagement, not prove a point or be right. Now, on some movies, and I definitely don't do this on every one, but for some movies, I'll also do some paid ads myself, mostly on Facebook because that's the one I know the best. And I've talked about this in the past. I had a whole video on it. I'll link to it in the description. I don't spend a ton on ads, $1 to $5 a day, depending on the project, and less than $1,000 overall, typically on a PR firm. And you don't have to stick to what I'm laying out here. There are plenty of other ways to promote. Film festivals, conventions, digital billboards, direct sales. I've talked to several filmmakers that do really well networking at conventions and film festivals. I don't do much of anything myself with those avenues, so I'll leave them for others to explain how to take advantage of. If you want to make more money with your indie films, subscribe now. But whatever you do, keep making movies.